Anyway, we're going to get started.
Oops, pardon. No pardon or anything. Oh, that's all that vegetarian food. It's always been the same. You want one in a caravan, would you? What a vegetarian. That's why they go on holiday on their own.
Keep moving sights.
That's amazing, is it?
I say, it's just when you appreciate these deodorants, and it's sitting under the lights like on the ball type. No, just under the arm. Oh, I see.
The Nissan dealers in Bolsworth. Right. So I can understand you. And I know that for the price of a pint of Bass, anybody, anywhere.
Anytime.
Yeah, we'll do anything. Well, and he doesn't look like it, because his music ability is so much.
Told me, enjoy yourself.
On a serious note here, Nigel and I won't be here for the next week or two, so... I know. Weep, yes, yeah.
Actually, you're not running away together, are you, Bob?
No. Actually, I'm taking my wife away to Italy. And Nigel.
Who's that?
You're taking your
married
wife away?
Nigel is taking Bet. He's taking her to Mallorca, actually. And the breakfast club last week, we had a little chat about it.
We did.
And it just turned out that... the resort he is actually going to is a resort my wife and myself went to a few years ago, and it is a lovely little spot.
Thank you, brother. Cheers.
A gem of a little spot. And actually, Nigel did tell me, he said, that it's a special place for them because...
We have been there before.
You've been there before, and it was actually the last place they went to before the family was started.
Yeah.
And he did say that actually... Betty said he thought that it could have been where your eldest was conceived.
Was it?
Yes, and he actually said, he said, if that Spanish waiter's still working there, he's going to kill
him.
I wonder why I was getting big portions. Not as big as the portion you were getting.
No, it is true, actually. We do think that's where she was conceived, but... Do you remember that bus shelter?
I remember Manuel.
You ask me if I know Manuel y Bandido.
No.
I know Manuel well, and you know. Manuel is the meanest, the toughest, and the cruelest bandido in all Mexico. Many men die from the hands of Manuel. His eyes are the cotton like the knife. Still you ask me if I know Manuel the bandido. Manuel is a good friend of mine. Why only just yesterday riding my burro through the hills just off to the east. Manuel here appear like a seaman of nowhere, pointing two big pistolos at me. He say, get off the donkey, empty your bucket. Hey, better you do like I say. And I pull on the trigger of my two big pistolos and blow a big hole in your head. Still you ask me if I know Manuel the bandido. I know Manuel well, and you know.
Come on, you gringos!
Manuel is the cleanest, the toughest, and the cruelest bandido in all Mexico. Many men die from the hands of Manuel. His eyes are they cut like a knife. Then you ask me if I know Manuel the bandido. Manuel is a good friend of mine. So I empty my pockets, he say.
Not enough.
He say.
Not enough.
He say.
Not enough.
Get on with it.
I think Manuel, he just have some fun. You get around the back and you lift up the tail and you kiss on the donkey's bum.
So I do, and I kiss the donkey's sheet, and then kissy me him on the ground. He waved the pistol, he laughed and said, so I shot him the donkey sheet down. Can you ask me if I know Manuel the Bandido?
I know Manuel well, and you know.
Manuel is the meanest, the dumbest, and the cruelest
Bandido in all Mexico.
How many men died from the hands of a man?
His eyes, they couldn't have been
done. Still you ask me if I know my Bandido.
I'll well, he's a good friend of mine.
But it's not me just frightened my donkey. It's also this I can tell for a fact. I can't remember one time once before when I lifted up his tail just like that.
Oh yeah.
So he started kick me, and he kicked Manuel. Manuel dropped the pistols down. So I picked them up, and I pointed them at him and say, Manuel, it's your turn now. You get around the back. You lift up the tail. And Manuel, you kiss his ass. And you eat some shit.
I left some for you.
Emmanuel, you think you're so smart. Still you ask me if I know Manuel Bandido. Well, amigos, what more can I say? Would you believe that me and Manuel, we had lunch together just yesterday? Still you ask me if I know Manuel Bandido. I know Manuel well, and you know Manuel is the greatest, dumbest, and the cruelest son of a bitch in Mexico. Many men died from the hands of Manuel. His eyes, they cut like a knife. Still ask me if I know Manuel the Bandido. Manuel a good friend of mine. Still you ask me if I know Manuel the Bandido. Hey, flamenco, no?
No.
No. Manuel is a good friend of mine.
Anyway, we've got a booking next week. We have got a booking next week, and it is that is one of these newfangled cameras. Do you remember the one Ron Laird had many years ago when it was all dark?
That was his little brownie.
It's not one of these illegal films.
So, no, actually, Bob, shall I explain what it's all about?
No.
Oh, yeah, but you can.
Okay. I was asked a few months ago if I'd like to put together a video. What would we call it?
Montage.
Video nasty.
John Donaldson came up to me and said we ought to have a la the Point of Vista Club. He compares this club to that band, and maybe it's the age of the people more than the atmosphere. I don't know, but. I'm just doing some test shots tonight. Don't worry, this isn't going on
that's
any
not the real thing.
Oh, that's right. Thing.
So I'm just looking at screen testing. And I'll be coming around testing your lights against.
So you're going to have to take a little bit more
Right, this is you, McCawson.
I'm at my love near Woolwich P. Beneath the big crane standing, and all the love I felt for her, it passed all understanding. took her sailing on the river flow, sweet river flow. London town was mine to give her, sweet Thames flow softly. Made the Thames into a crown, flow, sweet river flow. Made a brooch of silver town, sweet Thames flow softly.
Talbot rams bottom in a zoo up at Blackpool one year, with his stick with its horse's head handle, gave a lion a poke in the ear. The name of the lion it were Wallace. The poke in the ear made him wild, and before you could say Robert, he'd upped and he'd swallowed the child. He was sorry the moment he'd done it. With children he'd always been chum. And beside he'd no teeth in his noddle. And he couldn't chew well, and he couldn't chew well, and he couldn't chew well, and he couldn't feel the lad, and he couldn't feel inside him as he lay on his bed of dry. And it might have been little lads of birth, little lads of birth. He wished him such happy return.
Yes, on our cultural exchange last week.
Guttural exchange? Is he trying to catch?
All right, Malcolm.
Actually, he, I must say, Annie was tiddly a few times.
Jolly good.
Right.
Relative to them.
Relative.
Yeah, yeah. You're not relative to him, are you?
Actually, I slept with Bob for 4 nights. It's like sleeping in a farmyard.
You didn't record that as well, did you?
All the noises and all the smells.
He said he could. I reckon you touched his erogenous zone. It's more like a parking zone or something.
It's open, isn't it, Mel?
Yeah.
I kept pushing the two beds apart, and he kept pushing them together.
I kept pushing them apart, and he kept pushing them together.
Yeah, pushing pull all night.
They were in different rooms anyway.
I heard you complain about all the cockroaches on the wall. And the guy says, well, pull the bed away from the wall. He said, we tried that. He says, they pulled it back. You talk about Malcolm. Normally, when I go out, I've been out on the drink, he normally pours the drink down the toilet. Stops him getting up in the night, doesn't it, Malcolm?
Let's get off while we're on top. So.
No, this is only just a tale. It could end up turning out better than the Royal Theme. Like they say, that's what's the name is, don't they? Better, yeah.
Oh, Bobby, he's going to dub the voices then.
Oh, are they? Mine's going to be West Indian, is it?
It better be dubbed the voices.
Mine's going to be Jamaican.
He could airbrush him out of it, can't he?